Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple announced WWDC 2021, or the Worldwide Developer Conference for 2021. Apple has this event every year, usually in June, and this is an event where they show off the upcoming versions of their software. So for example, iOS 15, I'll talk more about those in a moment, but this event was announced today on their website, as well as they sent out emails to developers. And if we take a look at the website, you can see at the top left, it says there's an Apple logo and says WWDC 21. There's a person looking at a laptop with glasses and a reflection of the date. It says glow and behold. And below that, it says the Apple Worldwide Developer Conference is coming to a screen near you June 7th to the 11th. You can watch this online, and usually the first day of the conference, June 7th, for example, is when we'll have the keynote or the presentation about the upcoming operating systems and products and more. And that takes place normally around 1 p.m. Eastern time or 10 a.m. Pacific. They have not announced the specific time for that yet, but they should announce it fairly soon. Or they could possibly announce it as we get closer to that time. So if we go into a developer app, there's more information there. You can download this for free. And under the developer app, you can see it says announcing WWDC 21. It gives more information, and then it will have more detailed information as to different keynotes and things in this app. So if you go into this, Apple is also doing a student coding challenge. As you can see here, it says now through April 18th, we invite students who love to code to submit their Swift Playground to this year's Swift Student Challenge. Winners will receive exclusive WWDC 21 outerwear and a customized pin set. And if you want to learn more, you have to be 13 years of age or older in the United States, or I believe 16 in Europe. But as you can see, if you scroll down, there's more information about eligibility, and you can apply if you wanted to do that. So that's available just like it is every year. So it's a Swift student challenge. Now, along with that, Apple also updated Siri to give us information about WWDC. So if we ask Siri when WWDC is, let's see if they've updated it. When is WWDC? And we'll see what it says. It's taking a moment to respond. It says on it, and we'll give it just a moment, and hopefully it's been updated with information before filming this. 21 Worldwide Developers Conference will be held online starting June 7th. You can get all the details at apple.com. And so you can see it's giving us up-to-date information. Before filming this, it actually talked about the previous year's WWDC. So this year it will be all virtual again. Hopefully we'll be in person next year, but it will be a virtual event. And this year we should expect iOS 15. Now, iOS 15 is said to have a bunch of new features, but it's from somewhat reliable sources, so we'll have to see if it's actually accurate. But the exciting thing is there's not a ton of information about it. So some of the things people have said that will be new in it is a new control center, for example, a rearranged control center. Whether or not that's half the screen again, like it used to be, or just something completely different is hard to say, but we'll have to wait and see for that. Also, some are saying that we'll have redesigned apps. So we could have a redesigned app store, maybe a redesigned settings page, as some people have said, that they'll rearrange settings. I know for sure I would love to see a rearranged settings page where they bring all of the options into the app themselves. Like they did a little bit with the camera, we could have maybe more options within each app. That's something I would like to see, but we'll have to wait and see if they actually update this. Others have said we'll have an update to notifications, as well as an always on display for newer phones, as well as maybe some new icons as well. I would welcome updated icons where the icons were a little bit more or had a little bit more depth to them, maybe like macOS Big Sur, for example, or a combination of the two. That's something I would like to see. I know not everybody likes that, but I've never been a huge fan of flat design, for example. We should also see iPadOS 15, where some people have said the widgets will be more customizable and be able to be moved throughout the OS. Right now, they're just stuck to the left. It'd be nice to be able to move them around, but that's something we could see as well. There's not a whole lot leaked about what iOS 15 and iPadOS 15 and tvOS 15 could bring, and I think that's a good thing. Apple seems to be really locking down their security, and I'm glad to see that we're not seeing everything about it, but we may see more before it's leaked. Other people are saying that the camera could have more focus on portrait modes, where it could have more advanced portrait modes, and maybe a rewrite of that. So there's a lot of people saying we could see a bunch of different things. So far, I think we're a little far out to see exactly what will be in it, but we should know more hopefully within the next couple of months. And of course, on the day Apple talks about it. Now on June 7th, we should see iOS 15 beta 1 release. Now, for those of you not familiar with the schedule every year, Apple releases the beta usually the first day of WWDC. So that would be Monday, June 7th. Beta 1 would be out to developers. Normally it will take some time before it comes out to public beta testers, usually by the time of beta 2, for example, or even beta 3. Then a final release to the public wouldn't be until September, usually the last 2 weeks of September, where they announce and release the next iPhones, with iPhone 13, for example. So we could see all of that, as well as watchOS 8 and macOS 12 with those announcements and release. So that's a typical timeline Apple has every year for those events. Now, as far as hardware to expect, well, last year, we didn't really have any hardware. Apple announced Apple Silicon coming to their Macs. They later released Apple Silicon at the end of the year with the Mac Mini, the MacBook Pro, and the MacBook Air with M1 chipsets in it. But this year, Apple's continuing that transition, and we have still to see the Mac Pro, the iMac, for example. And in previous years, Apple has announced the iMac Pro on WWDC, for example. So we could see a new product. We could see something just redone, maybe the iMac, or we may see nothing at all. We'll have to wait and see, but that could be anything from a new development of Apple Glass, maybe a new operating system, or maybe Apple will surprise us with something completely new, which is what I always welcome. I would love a rewrite of iOS 15, for example. So all of those things are what we're waiting for. You can expect all of those different versions to release and maybe some new surprises as well. Now, for those of you that have been asking me, where is iOS 14.5 release candidate or beta 6? Well, at this point, I'm thinking that we'll see maybe beta 6 or release candidate tomorrow or Thursday. Last week we had beta 5, so I would expect beta 6 or a release candidate this week. So far, there's no mention of an Apple event in April, although quite a few people are saying that there will be one. So we're waiting to see if we're going to have announcements for that. Then we'll know a more finite date for, say, the release of iOS 14.5, where if we do have an event, generally that version would release after the event. So if we had an event on the 6th or the 13th, for example, or the 20th, normally it would release after that. So far, Apple has really changed the way they're releasing these, so we'll have to wait and see. But I just wanted to share a little bit about iOS 15, what I think might be in it, what people have said, and also what to expect for WWDC 2021. Let me know what you're looking most forward to in the comments below, and of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.